there are 4.6 million first responders in the United States, which include firefighters, police officers, paramedics, and EMTs. Predator-induced fear caused PTSD-like changes. An article by Scientific Reports claims individuals exposed to predator cues manifest an enduring memory of fear, demonstrating high sensitivity to predator danger. This can be attributed to first responders because, according to the Journal of Emergency Medical Services, at least 30% of first responders experience mental health issues such as stress, anxiety, and depression as part of their job function. This leads me to my research question: to what extent does daily exposure to traumatic events impact first responders' mental health? To answer this question, the scientific lens must be taken into consideration. According to Lena Robinson-Kitt, doctor of philosophy at the University of British Columbia, emergency responders typically have higher levels of exposure to the experiences that are implicated in development of PTSD and other psychological difficulties. According to this graph by Live Another Day, a website dedicated to providing recovery resources, it is clear first responders have increased mental health issues. As you can see, first responders have significant increased rates of anxiety, PTSD, sleep disturbances, and risk of suicide than the general population. Lastly, the culture surrounding first responders in the workplace must be taken into consideration. People who call 911 are typically described as having the worst day of their lives, but what about the first responders who witness these tragedies every day and are expected to be able to cope? According to Lena Kitt, previously mentioned, first responders are not only exposed to the stress of the traumatic event itself, but also the stress of working in a workplace in a culture that discourages emotional responses. They are expected to be superhuman and move from one crisis to another without feeling emotions. As shown in this graph from a survey conducted by the University of Phoenix, 39% of first responders say there are negative repercussions for seeking mental health help at work. Of these 39%, 55% say their supervisor will treat them differently, 45% say their coworkers will perceive them as weak, and 34% say bringing up mental health concerns will cause them to be overlooked for promotions. Considering the detrimental effects of trauma, it's essential a solution is imposed. To address the lack of workplace support, my first solution is to increase preparation and training for first responders' families. According to the Canadian Journal of Psychiatry, lack of support from employers and workplace environment can exacerbate the physical and mental needs of first responders. According to the National Library of Medicine, family members are in close proximity to the trauma, immediately available to their first responders, and can learn to identify behavioral reactions that may be linked to traumatic events. When asked about the preferred source of support, 49% of responders indicated their spouse, 35% selected family member or friend, and only 16% reported they would talk to a colleague. By training family members in psychological aid, existing social support will be strengthened and potentially help break down stigmas. However, with every solution comes its limitations. This solution is not available to everyone, as not everyone has family members they can trust and rely on. Additionally, Teresa Fadner-Baxter, clinical case manager at St. John's Hospital, recognized secondary stress disorder as a complementary disorder with similar symptoms as PTSD that can affect family members living with and caring for traumatized first responders. Due to the limitations outweighing the potential implications, I have developed a stronger solution. As mentioned previously, first responders are expected to move from one crisis to another without feeling emotion, pain, or remorse. Under the FFRCA, employers are required to provide up to 10 paid days of sick leave for employees. However, first responders may be excluded from this by employers. According to Johns Hopkins University, when employees are psychologically healthy, they tend to be more motivated, engaged, and productive in their work. Johnson & Johnson, a pharmaceutical industry company, found increasing mental health days for employees enhanced workplace motivation. Unfortunately, this solution includes limitations. Paid mental health days ultimately leads to money loss for companies. According to Margaret News, Margaret police and fire personnel have logged a total of 45,736 hours, sick hours at a cost of $1.6 million. Overall, traumatic events have detrimental effects on first responders' mental health, which is further worsened by workplace culture. Without taking action to change workplace culture and provide relief, mental health problems and first responders will continue to rise. These are resources I use to develop my argument.
Thank you very much. We'll get started with the first question. What evidence did you gather that you did not use, and why did you choose not to use it?
As I researched, I gathered evidence on how repeated trauma can cause first responders to overdose. However, I chose to exclude this evidence because I couldn't find any specific statistics on overdosing and chose to base my research on suicide overall.
Thank you. And also, if you had more time, what additional research would you conduct related to this issue?
If I had more time, I would research on the behavioral effects of trauma. Rather than focusing on PTSD and suicide overall, I would also dive in deeper into how the consumption of alcohol and drugs, how first responders resort to consumption of alcohol and drugs as a means of relief.
Thank you very much.